One of the other questions we asked in this 2014 survey, a repeat favorite of ours from prior surveys, is what stopped the bullying? And for the respondents for whom the bullying has stopped, there were several options. It falls on the target or the perpetrator. The target, there were four options. Three of them are job loss options. Quitting voluntarily, being terminated, being constructively discharged. In other words, being forced out of your job because work conditions were made deliberately worse, as the wording of the item. You could also be transferred. Now, being transferred meant you kept a job, but you lost the original particular job that you used to love. We don't call that job loss. It's a negative, but not a job loss. For the perpetrator, there were two job loss and one particular negative. Punished but kept job. Perpetrator was terminated, or perpetrator voluntarily quit. First, the good news. Never before in our surveys have we seen such a high perpetrator negative rate. They have never been punished at such a high rate, at least according to the public. Looking from the outside, the public believes that bullies suffer at a pretty high termination rate of 10%. We've actually never seen that. Now, bully targets do not report such a high rate. They report a 5% termination rate. But those numbers are going up, whether it's the public highly optimistic 10% or the target's rate perception of 10%. Pretty high. So bad things are happening to bullies. By comparison, it's nothing like what targets are going through. To tell you the truth, what ends the bullying is the target still pays a tremendous price. When you look at all of the potential options for stopping bullying, they are as follows if you take a look at this diagram. The target is fired 13% of the time. The target quits 29% of the time. The target is forced out 19% of the time. That's a 61% job loss rate. Let me say that again. For having the bad luck of being targeted, for having an unwanted, uninvited assault on your life, you have a 6 out of 10 chance of losing a job, losing your economic livelihood, losing your ability to support your family. That's how bullying ends in America. It's really sad. It's really pathetic. That rate is even higher if we don't count transferring. It skyrockets to 80%. But it's bad enough at 61% when we include all the data. So that is indeed the rate. In other words, perpetrators, though they're starting to suffer a little bit, targets suffer the most. And women targets suffer the most. And women perpetrators suffer more than male perpetrators. So, you see, that's part of the story. We've got to reverse this. There's no accountability when targets are the ones who pay the price unilaterally.